This video is about ammeters and voltmeters, two measurement devices we use in circuits. These are the symbols for ammeters and voltmeters. Ammeters measure the current in a wire, so literally they're like amp meters. They must always be placed in series with the location being measured. I'll explain why in just a moment. And an ideal ammeter has a resistance of 0 ohms because any resistance would change the current being measured. So again, I'll do some examples of that in a moment. A voltmeter measures the voltage in a wire, and voltmeters must always be placed in parallel with the location being measured. Again, I'll explain why in just a moment. An ideal voltmeter has a resistance of infinity ohms. It has an infinite resistance because it needs to stop any current from moving through it and taking away from what it's measuring. So just as an example, I can see here that using V equals IR and the equivalent resistance of the circuit is 5, that the total current moving through the circuit is 2 amps. So if I were to place an object to measure the current, I need the current going through that measurement device to be the same as the rest of the circuit, so I would place it in series with the rest of the circuit, because the rule is that in series, the current stays the same for all objects, so that 2 amps is also going through that ammeter. And because this is 0 ohms, the total equivalent resistance of the circuit is still 5, which means that the total current is still 2. So if we keep this at 0 ohms, it's not going to affect the current at all. So we would say the ammeter reads 2 amps. So we would know that 100% because we know that 2 amps are flowing through the region where the ammeter is placed. We call an ammeter with 0 ohms an ideal ammeter, so this is an example of an ideal ammeter. We put it into the circuit without it affecting our measurements at all, so because it perfectly measures the circuit itself without affecting the results, we say that it's an ideal ammeter. So 0 ohms of resistance means an ideal ammeter. Now let's imagine that we place an ammeter down that does not have a resistance of 0. Let's say it has a resistance of 5 ohms as an example. I can see now that the equivalent resistance of the circuit is 10, 2 plus 3 plus 5, because the ammeter is in series with the other resistors. So that's going to mean that the current is now 1 amp, because V equals IR, so 10 volts divided by 10 ohms of resistance is equal to 1 amp of current. So this ammeter is now changing the current that it's supposed to measure, which is bad. We do not want our measurement devices to change what we're trying to measure. So this is an example of a non-ideal ammeter. This is something that's changing the results. And unfortunately, in the real world, all ammeters are non-ideal to some extent. Most of them have very low resistances and we can get very close results, but there's no true ideal ammeters. Now we can add a voltmeter and measure the voltage with it. So I'm going to imagine that we're measuring the voltage across this 3 ohm resistor. So to do that, according to our rule, we need to put the voltmeter in parallel with the part of the circuit that we want to measure the voltage of. So here I want to know how much the voltage drops as the current crosses the 3 ohm resistor, so I put that voltmeter in parallel with the 3 ohm resistor. So I'm going to take a moment to show you why it is that we place that in parallel and why it is that we need that voltmeter to have an infinite resistance. I'm going to show you both right now. So to build up your intuition on this, we don't want any current moving through that voltmeter. Ideally, the voltmeter wouldn't be affecting how much current is moving through the 3 ohm resistor. It wouldn't be taking any for itself. It's just leaving the current to move through the 3 ohm resistor. So if that voltmeter has an infinite resistance, and resistance is the voltage drop over the current, that means that infinity is equal to the voltage over the current, and that basically leaves two options. Either the voltage is equal to infinity, or I is equal to 0, because as a denominator approaches 0, the value approaches infinity. And we know that the battery isn't giving infinite voltage to this circuit, so the only other option is that the current in the voltmeter specifically is 0. So if we make that resistance infinite, no current will pass through the voltmeter, leaving the current in the circuit unaffected. I can also show that the equivalent resistance for that parallel part of the circuit, because 1 over infinity is the same as 0, is just going to be 3 ohms. So because the resistance of the voltmeter is infinite, the equivalent resistance of that parallel part of the circuit is just the same as if the voltmeter weren't even there, if it were just the 3 ohm resistor. So this is good. We want ideal ammeters and voltmeters to basically behave as if they're not there. They're just measuring what's already present without affecting it at all. So this is the reason why we want an infinite resistance on voltmeters. So because the total resistance in the whole circuit is still 5 ohms and the voltage is 10, the current is still 2, and because no current is going through the voltmeter itself, all that current is going through the 3 ohm resistor. So I can see that the voltage drop is 6 in the 3 ohm resistor using V equals IR. And because the voltage is the same for all paths in parallel, that means that the voltmeter is also experiencing a 6 volt drop. So because that's moving through the voltmeter as well, the voltmeter can detect that, and that's how we read the voltage drop on the 3 ohm resistor, by putting the voltmeter with infinite resistance in parallel with it. So we would say the voltmeter reads 6 volts, and this is an ideal voltmeter because it is not affecting the voltage drop of the circuit. We can measure any region that we want with a voltmeter. For example, we could put it like this, and in this case, we're measuring the voltage drop across both the 2 ohm and the 3 ohm resistor. And again, we're giving this infinite resistance. And so this is still a 2 amp current, and so therefore the voltages are still 4 and 6, so altogether the total voltage here is 10. And you can also prove that that's 10 by saying, oh, well, those two resistors are in series, so they add up to 10, and the total resistance on one side of a parallel circuit is the same as the other, so in the voltmeter, that total voltage in the voltmeter must equal the voltages in the other side, so when you add those together, you get 10. So again, the voltmeter is just measuring that total voltage drop across that region. So here we would say the voltmeter reads 10 volts. If we put it over here, there's no voltage drop. All the voltage is happening here in the resistors. So because there's no voltage drop there, if we put the voltmeter there, that would just read 0 volts. Now let's look at a non-ideal voltmeter. I'm going to give this voltmeter a very high resistance, but not an infinite resistance. So this is 1 kiloohm or 1,000 ohms. If I plug this into my equivalent resistance equation, I can see that the equivalent resistance of that part of the circuit is going to be 2.99 ohms. So very close to 3 ohms, but not quite. Because the voltmeter is not ideal, it is ever so slightly decreasing the resistance of that part of the circuit. So when I add this to the 2 ohm resistor and then use V equals IR, I find that the current moving through the circuit is 2.004 amps, which is just a little bit too big. It's just a little bit bigger than what we had before. So I can see that the voltage drop in that first resistor is going to be 4.008 volts. So that means that because the total voltage is 10 and it dropped 4.008 volts, the second voltage drop across that parallel arrangement is going to be 5.992 volts here and here. So the voltmeter ever so slightly changed the voltage that it was trying to measure because it didn't have an infinite resistance. So we would say that this is a non-ideal voltmeter. Any voltmeter with a non-infinite resistance is non-ideal. There are going to be specific problems that ask you where you should place voltmeters and ammeters to measure the voltage and current in different resistors. So just as an example, I'm just going to throw a bunch on this circuit and tell you what each one is measuring. So this one can measure the voltage drop across resistor 1. This one measures the voltage in resistor 2, resistor 3, resistor 4. We can also measure across both resistor 2 and resistor 3, or across the whole parallel arrangement like that, or even across all the resistors in the circuit together. For the ammeters, this ammeter can measure the current moving through resistor 1, which you can see is also the total current in the circuit. If we placed it right here, it would measure the current in resistor 4, and if we placed it right here, it would measure the current in resistors 2 and 3.